Hi, this is Jitesh Satyan. WhatsApp number +91 965 66 11 829. Today's short talk is on the essence of Chapter 4 of Devi Gita. Chapter 4 deals with Yoga for Self-Realization. Devi mentions that study of scriptures, control of body through yoga, performing rituals, offerings, and all this will not be enough to see the Virat form of Devi. Devi's Virat form can be viewed only with her grace. Ignorance, avidya, is the cause of samsara. From ignorance arises kama or desire. From kama arises actions, karma. The goal of life is to destroy ignorance and get liberated, moksha or mukti, while living itself. Action is the result of ignorance. Hence, action alone cannot destroy ignorance. Actions, which is karma yoga, should be performed to purify the mind and control the body. Then the goal should be to approach a competent guru and get knowledge, jnana yoga, by undergoing shravana, which is listening to scriptures, manana, contemplating on the teachings, and nivithyasana, meditating to inculcate, experience, and establish the knowledge. Goddess brings up the importance of Upanishad Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, you are that, and explains that the consciousness of Brahman and the consciousness of Jiva are the same. Both are pure consciousness. Examples are given from various Upanishads to establish this unity. Hrim mantra can be meditated as separate parts, ha, ra, I, m, to establish unity between the individual body and cosmic body. The whole Hrim represents the Supreme Brahman, which is the state of bliss called Turiya. Realization that individual consciousness and Brahman are the same. Subject and object of meditation becomes the same. This is the Turiya. The meditation should be practiced by performing pranayama to regulate prana, then mentally dissolve the gross body, which is ha, into subtle body, ra, then the subtle body, ra, into causal body, and finally dissolve the causal body into the state of bliss called Turiya, which is Hrim. So the four-part division of Hrim is discussed here, similar to the four-part division of Om, Pranava, which corresponds to the four different states of waking, dreaming, deep sleep, and Turiya. So similarly, that's from a consciousness perspective, and from a body perspective, the gross body, the subtle body, the causal body, and finally Turiya, the state of bliss. So in this chapter, Hrim meditation is discussed, and also there's a discussion on Jivatma Paramatma Aikya. So first, Jivatma Paramatma Aikyam, and a meditation on how that can be realized. Thanks for listening.